Hello and welcome to Maths by SAS. This is my sixth lesson of D2, chapter number 12, exercise 12D, that is about the volume and surface area of composite figures. In this lesson, I will discuss intermediate level question number 7. Let me read the question from the book, as the questions are long, so I have written the question in short form. Question 7 says, a storage tank consists of a hemisphere and a cylinder which share the common base. Okay, the tank has a height of 16.5 meters and the cylinder has a base diameter 4.7 meter. Find the capacity of the tank. Okay, if we look at the diagram, we can see that in this situation, the solid which is given is consisting of cylinder and hemisphere. In this situation, 16.5 is the total height, which consists of the height of cylinder and the height of hemisphere as well. And second important thing is that we are given with the diameter of the cylinder or sphere. We are not given with the radius. We know that the radius equals to diameter divided by 2. So 4.7 divided by 2 will give me the radius, 4.7 divided by 2, and radius of this situation is 2.35 meters. Okay, now second problem with the question is that the requirement of the question is the capacity. And what is the meaning of the term capacity? Capacity means that the maximum amount some object can hold, that is the capacity. In order to find the capacity of this solid, we have to find the total volume. And for the total volume, I have to find the volume of cylinder and volume of hemisphere. Formula for the volume of cylinder is pi r square and h. Pi r square and h. We have the radius with us, but what is the height of cylinder? That is not given. This 16.5 is the total height. So we know that the height of hemisphere is equal to the radius of that hemisphere. Height of hemisphere is equal to the radius of that hemisphere. Okay, so the radius of this hemisphere is 2.35. It will be 2.35 on this side as well. So height of cylinder will be equal to 16.5 minus 2.35. This is one of the important point that we have to understand. 16.5 minus 2.35, and this gives me 14.15 is the height of cylinder. Okay, now I hope after finding the height of cylinder, the question will be really easy for my students. Now we have the height of cylinder with us, we have the radius of cylinder and hemisphere with us. So in order to find the capacity of the tank, that will be equal to the volume of cylinder plus volume of hemisphere. So what we are going to do first is that we have to find the volume of cylinder and total volume equals to volume of cylinder plus volume of hemisphere. Now it's a time to write on the formulas carefully. Volume of cylinder is pi r square h, and volume of hemisphere is 2 by 3 pi and r cube. Now pi and r square is the common factor. I will be pulling it out. I will be taking it as a common factor, and inside the bracket h plus 2 by 3, and pi and r square is out r. Now it's the time to replace the values carefully. Pi and r is 2.35 whole square. Height of cylinder is 14.15. 14.15 plus 2/3 into 2.35. Okay, now 2.35 square, 2.35, this is 5.5225 pi, and 14.15 plus 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2.35, this gives me 4.7 divided by 3 divided by 3, and this gives me 1.57. okay, now what I have to do is 5.5225 pi, and then what we have to do is we have to add up 14.15 plus 1.57, and this gives me 15.72. and now 5.5225 multiplied by 15.72 multiplied by pi, and pi has a value 3.142225 multiplied by 15.72 multiplied by 3.142, okay, multiplied by 5.5225 multiplied by 15.72 multiplied by 3.142, this is 272.7. As we have to give our answer nearest to three significant figures, so it will be approximately 273 meter cube. So the capacity of the tank is, so the capacity of the tank is 273 meter cube. I hope you are clear about this question, and let's move to the next question. And the next question says, a solid metal ball of radius 3 centimeter is melted and recast to form a solid cone of radius 4 centimeter. Find the height of the cone. Okay, in this question, the question says that we are melting a solid hemispherical ball, and when we are melting that ball, we are reshaping that ball in form of the cone, and the cone has the radius 4 centimeter. We have to find the height of this cone. So what we are going to do is we have to find the volume of spherical ball, and we will be equating that volume of spherical ball by the volume of cone. Because what is the reason that we are equating both the volumes? Because the same volume we are transforming in form of the cone. So we will be using this concept, that volume of sphere, volume of sphere will be equal to the volume of cone, volume of cone. And what is the reason? Because we are melting, we are reshaping, we are redesigning this sphere in form of the new solid, that is cone. So the both will have the same volume. Okay, now let's move to the solution of the question. For sphere, radius is 3 centimeter. Formula for the volume of sphere is 4/3 and pi r cube. And now what I have to do is I have to replace the value carefully. 4/3 pi r cube, r is 3 cube, 4 into pi into 27/3. 3 ones are and 3 nines are. 9 times 4 is 36 and pi, and let it be as it is. Okay, now volume of cone half cone. Formula we know is 1/3 pi r² and h. Okay, now what we have to do is that 1/3 pi and the radius of the cone is 4 square and h will be as it is, which is the requirement of question. So this will become 16 pi/3 into h. Now as volume of sphere equals to volume of cone, so from 1 and 2 what we can do is that this 36 pi, which is the volume of sphere, will be equal to the volume of cone 16 pi/3 into h. Now pi, I always ask it to my students to learn to make your calculation easy. This pi is same, so I will left with 36 multiplied by 3 equals to 16 h. okay, and then in order to get value of h, shift 16 to other side. 36 multiplied by 3 upon 16. Okay, now read the tables. 2 8s are and 2 18 times 2 4s are and 2 9s are. This will give me 9 multiplied by 3 is 27/4, and 27/4 can give me 6.75. So the height of cone is 6.75 centimeters. I hope you are really clear about today's class. For next difficulty level, please catch me in the next class. Please watch my lessons, like, share and subscribe the channel, and press bell icon to get the notification of every lesson in time. Thank you very much.